Hello mommies and daddies, welcome back to our channel My Career Motherhood. I am Pratiksha and I'm welcoming you again to the our channel. So the topic of today's video is what we should do when our baby fall, or what precautions we should take so as to avoid our baby's getting fall, and when the baby gets fall, what are the things we should keep in mind, what home remedies we can do, when what kind of injury can ask us to go to doctor, and what are the injuries which we can treat at home. So in this video I will be discussing about all the things which I have experienced in my life and which you must have also experienced, and in case you have not experienced, you must be you must be aware of what things you should do as a mother. So getting a baby fall is a very is such an incident that make us feel like crying. So just don't get nervous, don't get scared, because growing, getting falling, burning, choking, suffocation are part of baby growth. We should be very, very strong. We should make our heart very strong so as to deal with such a situation. And rather than feeling yourself guilty, you should make your child also brave, that don't get nervous. These things can happen, but yes, the things we should keep in mind, that what safety measures we should take, what precautions we should take so as to avoid such incidents to happen again in our life. So in this video I will be dealing with the topic of baby fall, choking, suffocation, burns. This video is basically, I've divided into two parts. Firstly, I will discuss with the problems which may arise, and the second thing, I will take few points out of them which we will be discussing in elaborate. So let's start with the video without wasting much time. See, first of all, I have made a checklist out here where I feel that these are the things which in day to day our life, these things arise. So first of all, we should be aware that we should take care of the things, we should discuss the points, watch what problems can come, and after that I will discuss with the problems and the solutions which we can take the necessary actions. So the things which may happen, that first thing is that the baby may fall from bed, they may fall from sofa, couch, changing tables, or any higher things such like that. The second is that the choking problem, suppose there's the baby may take part of a toy, they may take in their mouth, because babies have a habit of taking everything in their mouth, they just try to explore different things around them, so they have a habit of taking each and everything in their mouth, so that may result to choking. So just keep away small things away from your babies. The batteries, the button magnets, they are very caustic and they may harm your baby. So this is the second point, that keep away small things from the babies. The third thing is that the car safety. If you have a car, if you are in your day-to-day life, you have a habit of going in a car, just make sure what are the things you should take care while you are in car, and if you are in using a car seat for your baby, what safety measures and precautions you should take in that case. The fourth point is that burn. See, generally a burn is a major injury which may happen to a baby, so just make sure that keep away the hot things like cup of tea or coffee away from baby, and while cooking, just make sure that when your baby is asleep and when you are sure that the baby won't come to your kitchen area or cooking area, then only cook. When the baby is awake, try to stop or try to avoid the cooking thing, because I know it's very difficult for a mother. We have to complete the whole lot of our household chores in a day, and the baby generally sleeps, sometimes they don't sleep, so just you have to manage your routine and do it according to your child. So make sure that you are not cooking, or in case you are drinking coffee or tea or having a cup of tea, or you are serving someone, just make sure that the baby is not nearby, because baby just don't give you chance to think and just rapidly grab the things, and that may cause burn to the baby. So what we should do in case of burn and all. Now what precautions you should take in case the suffocation arises? What should we what are the things we should avoid doing in case of suffocation so that a suffocation don't arise to a baby? The next thing is that our balconies and windows of a house, we generally have balconies with half railing and half is open. So when the baby starts walking, they tend to climb up and that may result to fall, and that may really cause death or major injury to your baby. And in case of windows, we have these sliding windows in all the houses, and in many houses grills are available in the window, but in many other cases grills may not be available. So what things you should take care in those cases? Next thing is that stairs and steps. If you are having a house in which there are 2-3 steps or stairs, or duplex triplex house, or you are staying in the first and second story of your apartment, so what precautions you should take in case of stairs and steps if there are in your apartment or anywhere you go? The next thing is that what precautions you should take in the bathroom area, the washroom area. The next point is that keep your floor of your house free of other items, unnecessary items, which may result to baby fall or any other slippery items. Just remove them from the floor. So in this video, we will be discussing about the things, but it may not be possible for me to cover all these points. So let's start with the first point, that is what we should do in case a baby fall. See, falling is very part of a growth of a child. So just make sure that the baby isn't in the close supervision of somebody in the house. And in case you are a nuclear family, I know it's very difficult. You should make your baby a priority. Other things may happen later. So just make sure the baby is in close supervision of an adult who is not dealing with mobile phone, tablets, iPads, computers, laptops, or is not intoxicated. You should be very much in keep the baby in mind and take care of the baby properly. So the baby should always be in close supervision, and as we know, close supervision is a key to safety. So just keep in mind the baby is in the close supervision of yourself or someone else in the house. So let's start with the topic, but before that I would like to share my first experience when my baby had a fall. My baby just completed 6 months, and 2 days immediately after that she had a big fall from the bed. The thing happened like that. I was making her sleep, and at the same time I also felt asleep, and suddenly after a few minutes I heard a loud sound, and when I got up I saw my baby was on the floor. Her head was lying like this. She was she fell towards her head. So I just got really very nervous. I had never heard what to do in such situations. So I rushed to my neighbors and I told about them that this thing happened. They immediately took a clean towel, put some ice cubes, and they started giving a cold ice pack compress on her head. And at the same time, I sat with her with that towel of ice and started breastfeeding her. As you know, breastfeeding is the best thing you can do at any situation your child is in, because that calms and soothes your baby so much. So I just sat with her and started feeding her, and at the same time I was compressing her head with the cold ice cubes in the towel. So she started crying less, and she got very calm. And at the same time I kept on touching all the parts of the head, because she was 6 months only and the head part was very soft at that time. So I just make sure that there are no bumps or swelling in her head. See, immediately it may not be possible you can see bumps or swellings, but you have to keep a watch of 24 to 48 hours, because in that time period you can know that if there is swelling or bruises or some thing in the head. And if you see anything like that, you just need to go to the doctor or your medical practitioner and just let them know what happened, so that the thing can be cured instantly in their guidance. So this was the first incident which happened to me. The second thing was that When my baby started crawling, I was playing with her in the bed with a ball, and the ball fell down from the bed. I just went to take the ball, and at the same time she just crawled and fell from the bed, and that time she fell towards her mouth. And what happened, she had a few teeth in the mouth, 4 to 6 teeth had already come, and from the upper teeth she got hurt in on the lips, lower lips of the mouth, and that started bleeding. I really got scared again, but somebody told me that in case such things happen, just put sugar or honey in her mouth. So I just rushed to the kitchen, I took some sugar and filled her mouth with sugar wherever I saw the blood was there. Now you are going to ask me why you have put sugar, what is the reason? See, sugar has healing properties. When sugar comes in contact with blood, rather I would say water, that becomes an enzyme which is called sucrose, which acts as a medicine and stops the blood at that time instantly. And the best part of sugar is that there is no side effect, rather the baby enjoys the taste of sweetness of the sugar, though it is recommendable that before 6 months it is not advisable to give sugar or salt to baby, but in such situations you can't avoid. And as such, my baby was already more than 6 months at that time. I just put sugar and she got calmed, and again I did the same thing, I breastfeeded her. So that situation was good enough, and I handled and I learned to handle the situation. And now my baby is such strong enough that even if she falls, I just ignore. If there are small falls, she was running, she's falling on the floor, I just don't pamper her, I run her and I give her hug, I don't do anything like that. I just keep ignoring, seeing the situation that yes, this is not such a big fall. So just she gets up herself, she hits the area that why you have bitten me, and she just starts playing and start doing her activities. So this two were my experiences which I have shared with you. But in case if you face situations, I rushed to doctor also. I'm really sorry, I forgot to tell you, I rushed to doctor when there was a first fall. My doctor told me that yes, whatever I did was correct, but at the same time he gave me a ointment, also a gel, which I really can't share with you because I want this to be you should deal with your pediatrician or your medical practitioner, and these things are to be done in their guidance also. So I'm not sharing with you that gel. But the question is that when should we rush to doctor? In case you see that the baby has fallen and there the baby has started vomiting, or there is bleeding from her ears or nose, you should then and there rush to your doctor. Or in case the blood is coming internally from the mouth rather than the cut lips or gums or tongue area, if the blood is coming internally, in that case also you should rush to your doctor. I am repeating again, in case the baby vomits and is bleeding from nose, ears and internally from mouth, then and there you should rush to doctor without waiting for a second. So this was the thing, when the baby gets hurt internally, sometimes it also happens that the baby get hurt in the outer area of the mouth. What should we do in that case? See, first of all, wash your hands with a nice antiseptic liquid, then clean the outer area of the baby with a soft cotton. Just dip the cotton in liquid with antiseptic, Sevlon, Dettol, anything like that. Don't apply Dettol or Sevlon directly because that give a burning sensation, they are little strong. So just dilute them and then clean the area so that whatever the dust particles or the blood gets dries up, that get cleans, and apply ointment, cream, whatever is available with you at that time. In case nothing is available, you can just use Borolin and Boroplus. Generally we find them easily in our home, so you can use them then and there. So in this way you can clean the outer area of the mouth. So this was the video, complete video, when there's a fall from bed, couch, sofa or anything, or baby directly fall in a floor and get a cut. So this home remedies of sugar and honey, or if there is outer cut, you can just treat at home easily. But in case the baby vomits and there is bleeding from ears, nose, just don't wait and rush to doctor. And in case you see any unusual habit of a baby within 24 to 48 hours, just rush to doctor again. Don't wait, because your baby is your first priority. Everything comes after that. So just make sure of the things. So this is a complete video on this. Make yourself strong, make your baby strong, don't get nervous, don't make yourself find yourself guilty that why such things happen. See, these are part of the growth of baby. Baby wiggles, baby shakes and do everything. You can't even think that what they are going to do in the next millisecond. So just be strong enough and let the things happen. Enjoy the moment with your baby. I hope you liked my video and it will be helpful for you. In case you liked it, just hit the like button, please. I really need it. And please subscribe to my channel. And if you have already subscribed, then lots of love from me. And also hit the bell icon beside the subscribe button. I would like to say that not only mothers, fathers also take interest in my videos. All the parents should be aware of the things. Because I want to make parenting so easy that everyone enjoys it. So this is a complete video. The other points which I have discussed regarding choking, burning, suffocations, bathroom take cares and all things, I will be continuing simultaneously. A video will be coming on that. So just stay tuned and just like my video. Thank you so much. Enjoy life, enjoy parenting.